Did you know that in Tibet, the statues of Buddha are made from butter? Surprised? The method of creating these statues is a little different. Buddhist monks dip their hands in cold water while shaping these statues to prevent the butter from melting. People then take these statues home and worship them. The Japanese make Buddha statues without the eyes. They pray for their wishes to come true, and only after their wishes are fulfilled do they paint the eyes of the statue. Thailand has a Buddha statue made of emerald. This beautiful and precious statue can only be worshipped by the king. It is believed that the day Thailand loses the possession of this statue, the country will be erased from the map. It is a popular belief that the tradition of making the statues of Buddha began while he was still alive. One fine day, Buddha vanished from his summer retreat and nobody knew where he had gone. A few days passed, but there was no sign of Buddha. So a worried student by the name of Anand consulted a psychic regarding his whereabouts. The psychic told him that Buddha had gone to heaven to pay his mother a visit. The entire Buddhist community was quite upset because of Buddha's absence. Udyan, the king of Kausambi, who was an ardent follower of Buddha, was so depressed in the absence of Buddha that he fell ill. Anand got a Buddha statue made for him by a local sculptor. The statue looked exactly like Buddha, and the king miraculously recovered after seeing that statue. After the death of Buddha, to preserve his teachings and make them available for the people, Bodh Kala began in 4th century BC. The paintings and carvings in the initial phase were designed to help people know about the greatness of Buddha the teacher. Turning of the Wheel of Dharma is his most popular depiction. It depicts Buddha teaching his first 5 followers. This is the first presentation of the beginning of Buddhism. Hence, it is quite significant for the Buddhist faith. After the death of Buddha, he did not have a direct representation for a long time. Sometimes footprints, a vacant throne, or a chandelier were used to symbolize him. Buddha never wanted his body to be given any sort of importance, as he believed that his message alone was enough. According to a Buddhist legend, representation of the footprint of Buddha can be dated back to 5th century BC. And till this day, the footprint is sacred for the countries that follow Buddhism. These footprints are known as Buddhapad, and this representation is an iconic stage of Buddhist art. This was that era of Buddhism in which there were no idols of Buddha. As we reached the 1st century AD, beautiful human forms of Buddha began to be created. The iconography of this era is known as anthropomorphic. Greek artists specialized in creating beautiful human forms. They started converting Buddha's human form into sculptures. 2 kinds of artists were involved in making Buddha statues: Gandhar school and Mathura school. Gandhar school was influenced by Greek architecture, and hence in their depictions, Buddha was shown wearing long robes and sandals just like the Greek gods. Buddha's standing statue is a direct influence of the Gandhar school. Thanks to them, to this day we can imagine Buddha in a human form. Mathura school of sculptures depicted Buddha as a Hindu god, so he was shown sitting on a lotus just like the other Indian gods and wore half-sleeved clothes. This resulted in Buddha looking more like a Hindu god and less like a human. The most interesting thing is that Buddha had a large influence on visual arts such as painting and sculpture, but not on music and dance. The specialty of Buddhist art is that each artist can depict Buddha in the manner he pleases. But since the art form has been here since a long time, there are some unsaid rules that are followed in a majority of the Buddhist iconographies. Like the hump on Buddha's head, which people think are his hair, is actually his wisdom bump, or the horn of knowledge. He shaved his head when he became a monk. But this wisdom bump now symbolizes Buddha. The fact worth noting is that Buddha's contemporary, the founder of Jain faith Mahavir, also has a similar wisdom bump on his head. Buddha's ears are shown to be disproportionately larger. One of the reason being, big ears are considered as a symbol of knowledge. And the second is that Buddha is known to lend an ear to all the problems in the world. Buddha's eyes are called lotus because his eyes were shaped like the petals of the lotus and perhaps even more beautiful. These wisdom eyes were so popular in Nepal that they are now a symbol of Nepal. Buddha is represented in some important mudras: Abhay Mudra, his state of being after acquiring knowledge; Anjali Mudra, his state of being in which he preaches about the importance of present time; Bhumi Sparsh Mudra, the state of being when he achieved enlightenment. Hence, with the changing of mudras, the mood of the Buddha statue also changes. Mahayana Buddhism is based on the principles of the Bodhisattva art, and the Bodhisattva art is a popular subject in Buddhist art. Bodhisattva literally means the enlightened being who has vowed to bring peace to the world. This art form can depict Buddha having many hands and heads. Along with that, the Buddha statues may possess many ornaments and weapons. Avalokiteshvara, which means the Lord who looks down on the world, is the most popular Bodhisattva. But its meaning has changed constantly with the passage of time. In this form, Buddha is considered to be the most compassionate one, the one who understands pain and who is kind and merciful. Initially, he was portrayed in the male form, but later he was depicted in male-female form as well. A Buddhist monk from Tibet, the Dalai Lama is considered to be an avatar of Buddha. Manjushri is a Bodhisattva that spreads awareness, and he is always depicted young in age and holding a weapon. He is sometimes seated on a lotus while sometimes on a lion. Many Bodhisattva are depicted in female form as well. Tara, Manjushri and Gwanyin are some of its examples. Buddhist iconography is really diverse. The reason for that is the local and regional influence. Point in case is Laughing Buddha. Agreed, this figure does not match the historical representation of Buddha, but this too is a representation of Buddha. His real name is Budai, or Pinyin, a local Chinese deity. And since his characteristics are so similar to Bodhisattva Maitreya, people started considering him as an avatar of Buddha.
Like, share, subscribe, and click on the bell icon to never miss an update from Epic.